Hi and welcome to another video on UiPath with me, Jeppe. In this one, we're taking a look at one of the activities in UiPath Studio, and that's the invoke code activity. So let's get to it. So maybe you have some old Visual Basic or C# code lying around. Maybe you have some very complex code that you want to simply import as easily as possible into the RPA space. And one way of doing that is by using the invoke code. So let's try and see a simple example. So in the toolbox, I'll drag in the invoke code activity. And we can see that it has a couple of buttons, one that's called edit code and one called edit arguments. And the edit arguments is very similar to the import arguments that we see when using the invoke workflow file activity, in that you define the different arguments, define their directions, their type, and their values. And we'll do that in just a second. First, though, we will define here in the outer scope a few variables that we'll use. And we'll define the first one as number one. That will be an integer. Number two will also be an integer. And calculation result will also be an integer. And I think you can see where this is going. So now we have three local variables and we'll assign values to them directly. 2, 4, and nothing to the calculation result because we want this code to perform that calculation. And I know this is kind of overkill because you could just do that in a simple assign, but for the sake of giving an example, I'm going to invoke some Visual Basic code to do it. So I will edit the arguments first. And this code will expect a few arguments. N1 will be the first number. The direction is in, the type is an integer. The next one is the second number. And that will also be of type integer. And then the last one will be result. And that will have the direction out because we're sending that back from this invoke code activity. And that is also of type integer. And then we will set the values of these arguments. And the first number will have the number one variable. The next one will have the number two variable. And for the result, we will set that to be returned to the calculation result variable, and we'll click OK. So now we have all of the communication between the outer scope and the invoke code activity set up. So now we want to define what is it that's going to go on inside of this code. And I think you've probably guessed it that we're going to take the first number, and we have IntelliSense autocomplete, whatever you want to call it in here. We can just type in first number because it knows the names of the arguments. We'll add the second number to that, and we will assign the sum of these two numbers to the result argument. So now we've simply made a calculator that can add the first number and the second number and return it in the results argument. And if we click OK, we can see that there are no errors. There would be a blue light up here if there was an error. And if we try and run this, and before we do that, we will get a message box. And we'll simply write result is, and then the value of the calculation result variable converted to a string. So if we run this very quickly, we get the result of 6. So that's how simple it really is to make this work. If you think of it as a workflow file, but a workflow file inside of which you have to write the code instead of drag and drop activities, UiPath Studio style, then the invoke code activity really isn't so scary. A nice little feature is that over here on the right, you can actually decide what language you want it to run. So right now it's running visualbasic.net. We could change that to C#. And it'll just take a second. And now we have an invoke code activity that runs C# code. And because C# code and Visual Basic code is not the same, we can see up here that it's making a fuss because there's an error in the code. So if we edit the code and correct the error, which is in C#, you need to finish each line with a semicolon and then press OK. There we go. Then the error disappears and we can run the code again and hopefully we get the same result. Right. So that's a quick look at the invoke code activity. I have lots of more videos on my channel here on YouTube. Give me a like if you like this video. Click one of the videos that are popping up now. and consider subscribing to my channel, and you'll get lots more videos. So, have a good day, stay safe, thanks for watching.